Now, fortunately, I like a lightly bronzer. Let's go to the iPad. Well, hello, my lovely nestlings, and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 44 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. Today, I am playing with the brand Max & More, which is a Dutch-based makeup brand. And as far as I know, exclusively sold at Action. I don't even know if they have their own website, because I know them from the store Action. If I can link stuff, I will. And otherwise, I'm not able to then. So yeah, I thought it would be fun. This is a very, very affordable makeup brand, and I am very excited to play with stuff. Now, I do love my makeup. I love drugstore, I love indie, I love colorful and neutral and everything in between, as long as it's cruelty-free. So if you like that as well, with a little bit of weirdness, or let's just say uniqueness, and sarcasm strewn in between, then don't forget to hit the subscribe button. We are in Vlogmas, so I upload a lot. I don't know if I upload every day, but I do upload a lot. So yeah, let me put on my reindeer ears and we can get started. Now I have almost a full face. I do remember though that I have tried their foundation before, and well, I think we only had 3 shades or maybe even 2. I remember that I did not get along with that foundation at all. So I did not get foundation or concealer. That is what I have on my face. And I also put in brow soap. That's it. Yes, that's basically it. And for the rest, I didn't get a mascara. I also didn't get falsies. But it's almost a full face. I'm very excited to play with this, guys. I have some very, very pretty stuff. Now let's start with... let's build suspense. Yes, I have stuff here. I have an eyeshadow palette. I have lip. I have contour, bronzer, blush, eye pencils. Did I say that? I don't remember. I have a lot. Let's start though now with brows, because that is basically what I do next. And I have a brow pencil here. Let me show you the close-up, because I filmed it. I felt fancy this morning. Yes. This is in the shade brown, and one side has also a sharpener, and the other side has a spoolie. So I'm actually quite interested. I usually use the one from Catrice, which is a very, very cool tone brown. This is a little bit more warm toned. Let's see what happens. Let's just put it in the brow. Oh, it's a very, very creamy formula, so I need to be very, very careful not to overdo it, because the one from Catrice is a little bit drier. Yeah, it is too warm for me, but it is a very, very creamy pencil. So if you like that, this could be for you. I don't remember what I paid for this, actually. So that is also handy, because I threw away the receipt. Maybe this is something for my sister. And why am I saying that? Just solely based on the color. I don't mind the formula. I do prefer a formula that is a little bit stiffer, though. But it is just too warm for... it's too warm for me. So let me grab my own pencil that I usually use, just to cool it down a little bit. So yeah, I do think that the color is a little bit too warm for me. When I combine it with my own pencil, I can make it work, but I prefer it if my brows are more cool toned. Okay, let's next go then to the, what is it, contour stick. Is it a contour stick or bronzer? For me, it's more a bronzer shade. Let me compare it to the one that I have from Kiko. Okay, so here I have my bronzing stick from La Ritzy that I have been using for quite some time, until I got the Kiko one, which is here. This is the one from Max & More, which is a little bit more of a redder undertone, I think. This is the Kiko one that I've been using lately, and this is the Fenty. So this is my contour shade, so it's not a contour for me, it's a bronzer for me. And it's basically between these two shades. It feels like a creamy formula. I'm actually quite curious. Let's also see what was the other side again. Yeah, I don't think I will use the other side, but why not? Because it's not a contour shade for me, I'm going to contour with my own contour stick. That is contouring done. Let's grab my a bronzer brush then and just bronze the way that I would usually bronze. And that is basically paint the brush. And then I tap it on my hand to see about the color. I know that I don't have to do this with the Kiko one because it's so light. And then I bronze. Okay, so I can go a little bit more ham, I think. It looks to be a very nice color. It spreads out evenly, which is very nice as well. It is a little bit more red than I am used to, but maybe I just need to get used to it. That could be it. I don't usually use I think I need to use this then as a highlighter part. Let's just... Oh, I don't think that was a good idea. Let me get my sponge. Yeah, that highlighter shade, I don't usually use stuff like that, but I can. I can just play around with it. It's... Yeah, it looks nice. Okay, so then we had that. What is then? Basically blush, but I don't have a cream blush. Do I want a cream blush? No, let's not use a cream blush then, because I don't have one. I do, however, want freckles, so let me put my freckles on. Something like that. Okay, let me clean my hand. I'm looking very shiny. Oh yeah, I also don't have a setting powder from them. I forgot. And I do want to though, so let me grab one. Oh yeah, and the freckle tint is from Lottie London. Now that I am lighter, I do like it. If I'm darker, I don't know, it's not cool enough, which is kind of weird maybe, but yeah. Let's next go to bronzer. So this is a compact with a bronze and a highlighter in the shade Goddess Glow. It looks very, very light. Just saying. The nice thing with that is that I think I can really build it up. And I have already put a cream bronzer underneath, so maybe that will save it a little. Let's see what happens. Now, fortunately, I like a lightly lightly bronzered face anyway, instead of a very, very heavily bronzered face. Especially now that we are basically almost in winter, you know? It's just weird for me, I don't know, when it's very, very cold outside and I have a very heavily bronzed face. It just feels weird. For me, that is. Okay, so the nice thing about this for me is that I can go ham with it. I don't know if I see it, though. I don't see it a lot. Maybe in the depth of winter. But if you are any darker than me, which is basically... Yeah, the CC cream is light, in the shade light, and it's a smidgen too light for me. So I am light, but on the medium side of light. Does that make sense? So I'm not at the pale side of light, but at the more darker side of the light. Let's go to the dark side. If you are medium, this will not show up. I think you will like this if you are fair, though. So there is that. Okay, let's go to the highlighter next, because I like highlighter underneath the bronzer. Let's go with a denser brush and see what happens. Very powdery. Okay, let's go to my Nabla brush. See what that one does, because it should pick up more. And I like to bring it down a little bit on my cheeks, especially if... Oh yeah, that's better. If I am wearing matte blush. Blush is also very light, so I don't know if it will even show up. Okay. Yeah, you know, highlighter wise, I don't really mind it. It is a little bit powdery. I can make it work, although it is it's a tad too light for me still. But yeah, again, I think that if you are fair and you like this type of highlight, you can make it work. I think that a brush like this is the best though. Or you could even pick up, spray and then put it on, or spray your face with a setting spray and then... Can I do that? Of course I can. I usually don't use a setting spray though. So let's just, I have a little bit of water here. I'm going to do the same thing as I would with an eyeshadow. So I have stuff on the brush. I don't even know if this will work though. I think it does. Yeah, it does. So now it makes it more intense. Can you see that? I'm not really one for the blinding highlight though. It's okay. There's also days that I forget highlight. So there's that. Okay. This is nice formula, but too light for me. And the highlighter is a little bit powdery. The blush is in the shade Dusty Rose. I don't remember if they had more shades actually. But yeah, this was the shade that I grabbed. I don't even know if I can make it show up, but we will see. I have here a brush, obviously. I know I am depositing product. I can kind of see it a little bit as well. But it is a very, very pale shade, which, yeah, it's just a very pale shade. So it is more, for me, more of a subtle highlighter. Or highlighter blush. I do like the shade though. And I can definitely make this work in winter. I cannot make this work in summer. But I do kind of like it. It gives me a little bit of a subtle, I don't know if it picks up on camera, but for outside when I look at the mirror, it does not look very, very bad. Yeah, that's it. I think that if you are fair, you will like it. If you are darker than me, you won't see it. So yeah, there's that. And that is what I have noticed with their face products especially, that the range is just very, very light. And I do really hope, or at least what I can get here at Action, and I do really hope that they can change that. Let's go to eyes because I want to. So the eye primer, yeah, you see it here. It's a hydrating prime and boost. I don't know. It's a squeezy tube. But that's okay. Let me see if I have a clean brush to buff it out with. Sure. It is white and I apparently got a lot. Okay. So it does not really have a base shade. It feels more like a cream, just like basically like an eye cream. It's thin consistency wise. It also, the consistency feels like an eye cream. And I think I tried this once before, but I don't remember what I thought of it. I think that was back in the day when I was like, yeah, eye primer. I can just as easily use concealer. You can. But yeah, if you are older, if you have texture in your eyes or eyelids, texture on your eyelids, I don't know. It makes it so much easier to use an eye primer. And there are very nice cheap eye primers available. So drugstore has some great options. Just saying. It doesn't really feel like an eye primer that I prefer, because I prefer an eye primer that stays sticky for quite a while. This one dries down very, very quickly. So yeah, if that is what you like, then this might be for you. Let's go to the eyeshadow palette next. Wow, I'm very, very excited about this. It's called Bloom. And the outside looks very, very pretty. I posted pictures on my Instagram and someone said that it reminded her of the Born to Run from Urban Decay. I was really impressed by the swatches actually. The way that the shadows felt, they felt nice and creamy. I did have to build some shades up to make them show up on my arm, because especially the top row here, you don't see it on my skin tone. But I do think that they can be very pretty on the eyes. And yeah, I do like the fact that they go a little bit darker. The black is a satin though, which I kind of get for this brand. Because a satin is easier to work with than a matte, especially that. And I also think it is because maybe satins in darker shades are easier formulated. I'm not sure, that's my theory. What do I want to do today? I don't know.
a little longer than a few minutes later.
Okay, I think I'm going to go for a neutral crease today. I know it's shocking. Let's start with, I think I'm going to start with this one. Then deepen it up with that one. And then I kind of want to play here as well with the darker shimmers. So let's do that. Eyes are set. This is going to be so weird. I usually don't work on set eyes, but that's okay. Okay, I'm going to start with that lighter. Or shall I start with that? Maybe that's fun. I changed my mind. Of course I did. I'm going to start with the peachy. I don't know why, but I'm going to start with the peachy, which is this one. I never set my eyeshadow base unless I have a base that is very well. That's so it's not. I'm lying though. The only time I set my eyeshadow base is if I have a base that is very, very sticky and I have a shade that I know that can give me a lot of trouble. Then I set my base, but I set it only where I'm going to blend. And I either use a bone colored matte or basically a skin tone matte if there is one in the palette. Otherwise, I grab my face powder. But yeah, I am just used to basically setting my eyeshadow. Wow. Setting my eyeshadow primer with the eyeshadow and tapping it on. And that's what I'm doing now. Now I should be able to blend as well because it's set. But wow. Okay. I don't know how these will layer though. It's so weird that I'm able to blend right away. So if you are looking for an eyeshadow primer that dries down quickly, and you live here in the Netherlands, can get your hands on this primer, this could be something for you. I don't know how shadows will stay on top of them though. I feel like I'm blending it away a little. Okay, it's a very nice shade though. And it does not feel powdery. I have a little kick up in the pan, but not a lot. And also this is a synthetic brush, so shadows pick up a little bit differently. When you use a real hairbrush, you usually pick up more shadow. But this is not bad at all. Okay, that's the first layer down. Now I'm going to go to a slightly smaller brush. So now I'm going to go to that dark brown here. With a smaller brush. The first brush that I used was one from BH Cosmetics. It is from their rose gold set, a number, I cannot read the number. It's an eyeshadow blending brush. Not the biggest one in the set, but I think one smaller. And now I'm grabbing the Morphe M506 for that darker shade. I have a little bit more kick up in the pan now. Let's see how it layers. Okay, so it blends on top very, very nicely. I'm also very interested in the eye pencils, or they're not specifically eye pencils, they are face pencils for eye and lip, so that's good. Not too shabby, people. Okay, I actually want to, is this a darker one? No, this is more of a purpley one. I actually want to use the black as well, and I know that the black is more of a satin, but still I want to use it, because I want to darken it up, because I want to play here a little bit. I need stuff to be a bit darker, so let's grab it just on the same brush. Let's see what happens. Do I have fallout? No, not really. Now, because this is a satin, it blends like a dream. I can see that already. And I don't mind dark satins at all. I understand. Now I understand them. I used to resent them, but now look at the depth. I understand them though, because for a lot of people, this is effortless, guys. Wow. I've had this palette for quite some time. I just never, you know, other things were more interesting to play with, but now I'm kind of sad that I didn't play with this earlier. But let's go back to the first shade. I'm just lightly blending over everything to blend the layers together. I don't know if what I'm going to do, if that will be pretty, but we are going to do it anyway. I'm going to go to this one, which is a steel gray. I just love shades like that. Now usually I use I always use a shimmer primer. I'm not going to now though. I usually use a shimmer primer, but I kind of want to see how they perform on their own, so let's not. It's weird, not using a shimmer primer. Let's just dab it on. Very pretty. Now, shimmery wise, they don't really need it. It goes effortlessly. Let me spray for the other side. So I basically pick up shadow and then spray with just a little bit of water. You usually get the same effect as with a glitter primer. It does make it more shiny though. Yeah, it makes it more intense. So that is nice. And I actually think that you can do this with the black as well and create a little bit more of a shiny black then. Let's go to, I don't know, let's go to this one because I can. Let's just use the other side of the brush. Yeah, this is a little bit more blue. I want to spray this one as well. Yeah, I prefer them sprayed. And let's also, just with this brush, I'm cleaning it in between. Go to the black again, spray it, and see what that does, because I'm curious. It does not really make it any shinier though, I feel at least. Okay, what do I want for the bottom? I'm really kind of sad that I put that orange there. I want the brown that I use a little bit more back, a little bit higher. They do layer, so that is good. Okay, I kind of need to erase some stuff. So for that, I am going to go to... Let's go to this shade, because this is almost my skin tone. And it is a matte. And I'm just going to make sure that the top edge is blended nicely. But I don't want any extra color. And that is where... a shade like this comes in, or my face powder, because I usually, I actually usually grab a face powder, but that's okay. Okay, it is basically time for eye pencil before I finish off my lower lash line. So let me show you a close-up and the swatches. They really surprised me by how creamy they felt. Now, these are just makeup pencils, so both suited for eye and lips. And that is very fun, because that basically means that you can use the funky colors for lippies as well, if you want to. I think I am grabbing the shade Dark Teal number 7. I think I'm grabbing that one. So let me put it in the waterline. I don't know how long these will stay. Oh, wow. I am going to go to this shade. And it's going to go underneath my eye. I know I haven't... It's not a lot of... shades that I've used, that was the word I was looking for. But yeah, this is basically what I want to do today. Now, I don't have the Born to... Wow. I don't have the Born to Run, so I cannot compare them to you. Okay, so I do have a lot of fallout now, which is not that weird. And I'm kind of used to it. It does wipe away reasonably well. I don't know, it's okay. Okay, in the corner highlight. Well, we have some options here, haven't we? I don't know, let's grab... I don't think you will see this one though. Let's grab this one. Let's grab this one. I'm going to spray. It's a bit more shiny than I thought it would be. But that's, I think, also because I sprayed it. So I have the lippy here. I have two lip pencils. The lightest shade is Creme Brulee. And I have also the shade, where is it? Muffin. I think the shade Muffin will complement the look the best. So let me grab that one. Let's see if I can do this without making a mess. Probably not. So the pencil feels very nice and creamy, which is good. And now the lippy, which is a very pretty color as well. Pretty? I don't know. Is this? Oh, it's a matte. So maybe it needs to dry down a little. Never mind. Let me put on liner lashes and all that, and then I will be back to show you the completed look. Do something here because that looks weird, and then I will also give you my thoughts on the stuff that I used so far. Everything is on. Here is the completed look. I like how it turned out. A lot, actually. The falsies I have on are the Style Paris. And that's it. And the rest you saw. Let me just go over everything that I have used today and give you my opinion, because I kind of have some. Let's start with the first thing that I used, which was the brow pencil. It is a little bit too creamy for what I personally like, but I could work with it no problem. It's just that the shade is just too warm for me. That's the only reason that I won't be using it again. That's it. I prefer a more cooler shade. That's it. That's the only reason I am... I'm going to pass it along because I won't use it anyway. The next thing then is the contour stick. Well, it's not a contour stick because if you want to contour with this, it's too warm. You want to contour... really contour with something that's a little bit more gray based, but I do think that the formula is very nice. It's nice and creamy without, I don't know, I feel like I need to really set it down, so it's a little less creamy than the one that I have from La Ritzi, which is not a bad thing at all, and it is a little bit creamier than the one that I have from Kiko. It's not a bad formula. I kind of like the formula. The color I kind of like as well. And for me, yeah, it is a little bit more red based than I am used to. But I do like the color, and I think that I can make it work for quite some time. If I am at my darkest, the one from La Ritzi, that's the darkest one that I have. That's then the shade that I need in deep summer or midsummer. I don't know. But yeah, I think that's it. If you are, well, because this is the medium one. Yeah, I think that if you are really medium, I don't know how much you will able to make this shade show up. I think you can, but it will be very subtle then. This side, I usually don't use it. I think use it as basically a cream highlight, but it's not really shiny either. It's not something that I use usually, because I don't really sculpt my face like... I'm making a mess. I don't really sculpt my face like that. But yeah, it's here, so I will probably try it. Because why not, you know? I like it and I will keep on using it. It will go in my makeup rotation. I like it a lot, actually. So that is good. Then we got, what did we have then? I set my face. Oh yeah, the bronzer and then the blush. Okay, so let's go to the bronzer duo first. It is that I put it on top of a cream product. Let me grab my favorite bronzer. Which is from Kiko Milano. So here is my favorite bronzer, and it is not that different in tone, although I do feel like the Kiko one is a little bit darker. Yeah, it is darker, I think. Oh, it's a lot darker. So here I have the difference. So here's the Kiko, and here is this one, and the Kiko one is pretty light for me anyway. So, yeah, it's not really... Yeah, I can swatch it on my hand, but you don't really see it. It is that I put it on top of a... basically a cream bronzer that showed up on me, because this is way too light for me, and I am not really that dark. I'm also not really fair. If you are fair, I think you can use this. I don't know, maybe if you are this skin color, you can use it to set your face with. There's a very narrow... I wish this came in more shades. I actually don't know if it did come in more shades. I don't think so. I think it was just this shade, and I'm very sad about that, because I kind of did like the formula of the bronzer. This one is, for me, not really what I go for. I could make it show up very well, so That's very nice. It's a little bit of a powdery formula, the highlighter. And if you go for subtle, then this is the one. This is something that you can go for. I will keep it here and see how much I will use it in winter. And otherwise, I will probably just gift it to I don't know, someone else. I think I have someone in mind that is pretty pale compared to me. So yeah, then we have the blush. The blush shade is pretty. It's a very subtle blush. I can make it show up, as you see. It's a very subtle blush. I like the fact that I can really go ham with it, but this is also a shade that I do like. But for me, when you are fair, this will be pretty. Light, it will be pretty, but a little bit more subtle. And yeah, darker than me, it will not show up. So yeah, I kind of thought that when I saw the shade. I don't remember if they have more shades. Actually, I don't remember. The next time that I'm at Action, I will check it out because I do really like the formula on this. So yeah, so this is it's not a fail. This is not really a fail either. Formula wise, color wise, it kind of is though. And if that is the only bronzer shade that they carry, yeah. The next thing is the eye primer. It worked well. It's just weird that it really sets. I don't usually use a primer that really sets. There's also not really a base shade. Yeah, it's not a bad. I don't know how often I will grab this. Maybe for eye swatching videos, because this is a hydrating one. And I don't really have to wait long for it to set. You know, maybe I will use this one for that again, because it's a hydrating one, but it dries down and it feels like a moisturizer. The shadows went on top of it very, very nicely. They stuck well, they blended well. So yeah, it's not really a lot that I can say with the shadow palette that I used. It works very nicely, but I can try it with other eyeshadow palettes as well. It's just that the formula is not really something that I go for often. However, sometimes I kind of do want a primer to also set my eyelids if I'm not using eyeshadow. Does that make any sense at all? I don't know. I will try it, I think. I hope so. But you never know with me, and I have a bunch of primers. I don't think it's a bad primer. It's just not something that I gravitate towards, because I want a primer that's a little bit more sticky. And that sets down a little bit less quickly than this one does. Okay, then let's go to the eyeshadow palette. The shades I used, I'm very impressed by. Again, the shades I used. I think they performed very well. I did not use them on top of a glitter primer. I also don't have any skipping, and sometimes, even though I have just put it on, sometimes I can see stuff fading already. Don't feel like it really does that. So yeah, what was this again? Was this six? I think this was 6 or 7 euros for 21 shades. I'm very impressed so far by the shades that I have used. I'm very impressed by. I do want to play with it more. I just don't know if I have the time. Well, I can make the time. If this is something that you really want to see from me, more looks with this specific palette, let me know down in the comment section, because I can. I think it is, I don't know, is it an alternative for the Born to Run? It could be. It does give me similar vibes. And the shades that I used so far, I really like the quality from. So if you see this in store and you like the colors, yeah, I don't think you will be very, very disappointed. The shimmers are not in your face intense and foiled, but they are very pretty, especially if you spray them. And this is a formula that I think is very flattering on textured eyelids. I do like a formula like this. So yeah, so far, first impression is I am not sad that I bought this at all. Then let's go to the eye pencils. Can I just say, wow, the way that they felt. When I swatched them, the color payoff that I had, very, very impressed. Now, I don't know how long it will stay in the waterline. It didn't irritate my eyes. I don't know if it is waterproof, but I do really like the colors. And I like the fact that you can use them for lips and eyes as well. That they are then eye safe. And I like the colors. Yeah, I think that these pencils are worth it. And I cannot wait to play with all the colors, because I think that they have put some very pretty colors in here. And yeah, let's go then to the lips. Lip pencil. It felt very, very nice. Very smooth going on my lips. I like both colors. I used this color today because it is a little bit more of the orangey that I have in my eyeshadow. I like it a lot. The lip, it says it's a matte, but I do have to say I had a lip plumper gloss underneath. I've had some of their matte lipsticks before and they felt really dry. This one feels really creamy. I don't feel like it really dries down, but so yeah, I don't understand the matte aspect, but I do like the color. I like the formula as well. So yeah, in my opinion, it's if you like, yeah, I like it. That's basically it. So I think that is it. So my overall thoughts on the products are that there are some hits and misses. And that there are just some things that I'm really impressed by. And to be quite honest, I did not think that I would be that impressed. Especially by the eyeshadow palette and the pencils. And I think that, yeah, that is going to be it for my video today. Let me know down below if you want me to do more looks with the palette. Because I can. And then that is it. Maybe, yeah, if there isn't a lot of interest, I will just use it either in my off days or in a get ready with me or, you know, something like that. And then that is going to be it for today's video. Thank you so much for watching. I'm going to go to the site to give a special thank you to the members that you will see scrolling on the screen right now. There is a link to join the members down in the description box. And that is it for today. Thank you so much for watching. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck. And I will see you very soon in my next one. Bye guys.